Fanatics turn to ban. E-homes turn to ban. Fanatics turn to pick.
Invoker.
E-homes turn to pick.
And just like that, we're straight back into things. Our second best of three starting up straight away. No big breaks or delays here. Fnatic against eHome is ready for your viewing pleasure. I'm Gareth in the JD Studios, and joining me all the way from Canada, Motpax. How are you doing, man?
Naga Sirens.
Ah, great. We need a big long break. Like, what, 3 minutes?
Yeah.
Feels pretty fast. Excellent. We're back. We're ready to rock.
I was legit expecting like 20, 25, 30 minutes break, something like that. Maybe 15 if things were going super speedily, but that was like a less than a 5 minute break between series. It's amazing. But eHome against Fnatic, best of three. This is Group B now, the second best of three from this one. Draft underway, as you can see. Bounty Enchantress, Earth Spirit, and Lone Druid all banned out.
Remaining.
But eHome have given Invoker to mid one. And this is by far his most played hero, his best hero by win rate. Just by his playstyle. While eHome start off with a Naga and a Faceless Void. Talk about this, Motpax.
What is there to even say at that point? I'm just pulling that out.
I mean, over in the other series, Empire against Secret, apparently there was a Spectre against a Naga. Empire took that game 1-0. And Lenvy, even with his Naga Siren, couldn't pull Secret back into things. But eHome Naga. Going back to this again, try and draw out the map. The Alchemist Radiant, Spectre Radiant. Time for the old Naga Radiance again.
I have obviously been poking around a little bit of Chinese data lately. Checking out some of the bans and picks of some teams, and I did notice quite a few Naga bans coming out. Not too many picks, but perhaps something that's been more favorable in scrims lately in China between a lot of these teams, because you're seeing like more bans than picks, so that then therefore that warrants it. Like something's happening, right? Like seeing Alliance perhaps trying it out and being successful with it. And is it still that versatility? Remaining. Is that still possible? Like, do you still have to ban a position one? That's interesting to me. I don't know. Like, are you still going to run a support Naga? It would set up still pretty nicely for the Chrono. Obviously, it's kind of like disrupt in the sense of you just throw the song, and obviously you can just Chrono in the middle of the song. It's not going to affect anything. It's not a Ravage that you can totally blow or anything like that.
That's coming out now. eHome, rid of the Sven, Death Prophet. Something eHome have been favoring a fair amount. Have you watched too many of eHome's games recently? Isis now back in a support role with Fenrir, Old Chicken, Zamid, Old Levin off lane. Alanum Carry was the one that I was really looking forward to watching and finding out exactly how he's faring there. I managed to catch too many of eHome's recent games, just have a look at their drafts and, you know, pretty standard stuff, Earth Spirit to Enchantresses, a hell of a lot of Enchantress. Out of the ordinary for eHome.
The usual. I've seen a couple of mix-up, but I did get to cast quite a few of them. Ice, I know, like, initially he was playing the Earth Spirit, and then sometimes they swapped out with Fenrir, depending on the other hero. Like, seen, I believe Ice one game played the Crystal Maiden while Fenrir played the Earth Spirit. And there was, like, one game where he, like, bombed a lot of spells for Ice. I think he was still getting used to the hero, maybe. And then the last time I saw him, which wasn't that long ago, he was totally destroying on the Earth Spirit. Maybe coming more into the fold, obviously. Pretty big role swap at that point. The other thing is they mostly just run Lone Druid. It's kind of the big thing. They can get it, they will, but that's obviously why it's been banned out here by Fnatic, but they like to run that for Old Eleven in the offlane. Very typical stuff, and they've done all kinds of fun stuff with that. We've seen they had an Axe one game from Lanem. Sick, very, you know, classic style from that safe lane. They'll run the TA as well, but this time, they need that puck up against the Invoker. Now, this does kind of come back to what we were talking about last game, where you don't generally tend to see the puck with the Faceless Void just because it's a lot of control without a lot of damage.
10 seconds.
But I don't know, like, how does Naga fit in that too? That's gonna be like a Radiance Naga. I also am still thinking, like, that's really not a lot of damage. That move us into support Naga at this point.
It's either that, or you look for damage from your supports, but without a Lion, you look towards like a Lina or something along those lines, a Disruptor for the Storm to add a little more annoyance into the control and make sure you can just right-click them down from on above. Through Dreamcoil, Chrono, and Kinetic Field.
Oh, you got a Disruptor now. It's gotta be support Disruptor Naga Siren with the Doom. Second best thing to Tidehunter, basically, in this situation, I would say. If you're thinking about here, you wanna really shut down through this song, Chronosphere, Dreamcoil, Static Storm combo.
You go for the fourth pick of it?
10 seconds remaining.
A little open.
That depends on what you want your core to be like. If you want DOD, go for that now. I'll just take it now.
Fanatics, turn to pick.
Classic.
So that does mean to be on the front foot. Game Fanatic. DJ's Doom. 3-4-3 on the Lion. Voker. So they're still looking for Et and Ohio's heroes. Ohio is still Tidehunter out there. Not gonna be any Chen or Enchantress creep sent towards the offlane though. So if you wanted to go for his like Nyx Assassin, which has been incredibly good, Nyx Lion and Voker could all pair up really nicely to find pickoffs and kills on Puck, Naga, whoever it may be. The damage out there between them. Final hero for Net, Spectre. Played a lot of Spectre outside of Sven and Gyro. He hasn't really played. He doesn't have the most diverse hero pool. He's kind of just solid on three heroes. Played a bit of Juggernaut here and there when he kind of needed to. But I think that's Nyx for Ohio, so I think the Spectre ban has to come out from E-Home here. I don't think you're too worried about a Gyro or a Juggernaut. The Spectre is super scary. Rude ban?
Fanatics, turn to ban.
Expect that one.
I guess just not feeling if they had anything that would match up well against it. Would have been kind of odd lanes, but you can definitely see it still working. Perhaps maybe like mid brood.
10 seconds remaining.
Plain Nyx. An Invoker, perhaps.
5 seconds remaining.
I mean, a couple different ways. Obviously, you can just go with a typical offlane brood and go for a mid Nyx. Probably even a safe lane Nyx. You can do whatever you want. We're still left in the pool of the big boys. We still have the Beastmaster. I don't think that they're going to try and squeeze that and still being like an offlaner like that brood.
10 seconds.
I'd rather see what you're talking about, like the Juggernaut or something.
E-Holmes, turn to pick.
Well, there goes your big Wombo combo. I guess OD, still okay.
You're definitely sold on Naga Siren support.
Oh, Nyx. What damaging support is going to, like... Yeah, okay, go with the Weaver.
Fanatics,
that's very solid.
Turn to pick.
I want to pick OD.
Again, it's a Weaver being picked into Doom and Lion and the Nyx and the damage from Invoker. E-Home's wave clear right now up against Forge Spirits and the push potentially coming in from Fnatic. But limited. One interesting thing though is Nature's Prophet has been ignored throughout this entire draft. Fnatic, is it going to be the Spectre for Net?
Remaining.
If you move this Doom into the one roll.
Really?
5 seconds remaining.
Give DJ something different.
Good timing window that you need to hit.
Reserve
Fanatic?
Time.
Yeah, like what's your goal?
5 seconds.
Are you gonna try and last? Nope. Appear to be the play. Makes sense.
And survive through the roll of E-Home and the damage of the Weaver with the Medusa. I think, yeah, the other four heroes, they can go hunting, can't they? That's why I wanted Spectre. I wanted Spectre to be farming somewhere, and the other four to be, like, hunting kills with Sunstrike and Initiation from Nyx and Lion. I guess this way, Medusa can just gank herself up and not care about the Initiation from E-Home, so if she does get ganked, okay, she doesn't have the aggressive flip potential of being able to haunt into a fight elsewhere. Also, she's very difficult to kill as the game progresses.
10 seconds
game, and everyone picking up their heroes. E-Home against Fnatic. Game number one here of this best of three.
Remaining.
All the other games are pretty much done now. I think we're into game number two. two of Team Secret against Team Empire.
Yeah, I heard Empire took Team 1. Exciting. Oh, sorry, go. Alright, we're already ready to rock here. Anything unusual coming out here? I don't think so.
So, ice, support Naga Siren. Over with a stout shield, Observer Ward TPs forward onto his lane, and so does Fenrir on this disruptor. Early vision is going to be key here. E-Home as DJ gets himself forward for this Observer Ward as well, onto the high ground. Well scouted out there by Fenrir. Oh, yes it did. They saw him. Bare glimpse. Zoom as he retreated himself away. Passing for Ohio, Mango. Plenty of regen and a stout shield. It wants Invoker. This is going to be the kicker here for them. Those Wraith bands, the Ring of Aquila is coming up for the Invoker just to keep those item slots fresh. Open up for the rest of all your progression, the Midas, the POTs, Blink and all of that. Something right. Down towards the bottom rune spot there. Mid one. I think something like 30 out of his past games, like 55-60% of his games have been played on Invoker in the C scene, until it just became permanent first ban fixture up against Fnatic. Then he started switching to like TA, bit of Zeus here and there. He likes his Zeus as well.
30 seconds.
Invoker is just that mainstay hero from mid one that has been dominating Southeast Asia, and it led to that 25 series win streak for Fnatic. Look, they've dropped one series against against. Oh my goodness, the Thai team. Trust. They lost one series against Trust over the past like 2 months or something like that. Absolutely insane run for them, beating MVP Phoenix in 3 qualifiers, Epicenter, Manila, and Frankfurt for ESL.
Yeah, they've solidified themselves here. Especially because MVP was really starting to make a name for themselves on the world stage. A lot of, big fans suddenly pop into the woodwork. Go MVP. Fnatic just answered right back with, no, Fnatic, we came here, we're playing to be the kings of SEA, sponsorship for a reason, brought it down in the little southeast region. It's nice to see, obviously, and the other big thing is that Mushi is not here, so 343 standing in their usual coach. Hasn't been impacting them too much lately. I believe it's been a little while that Mushi's been, a week and a bit.
If anything, Fnatic have looked as strong, if not maybe even stronger, with 343's drafting and captaining and coaching and whatever else he's doing. Looks incredibly potent. How can they face up against the best of China, Europe, and North America here at ESL 1 Manila? While DJ on this Doom is up a top lane with Ohio, so far a dual lane for them.
Nice mint too.
An ensnare maybe? He's not leveled anything up just yet, so he has Riptide available if he wants it, or an ensnare to catch mid one. The off guard is Old Chicken. He hits level 3, so the 2 points in Illusory Orb available now. Mid one might be open to getting ganked here. The Riptide is there, and the jump forward, the Force Spirit out, and mid one. He's got a Fairy Fire in his salve. He turns around onto Old Chicken, the Phase Shift is available, and ISS turns to try and fight it. Maybe the trade off of salves, it looks like so far.
Pretty interesting here to have sitting in the mid lane. Impressive that you're actually able to get that much harass off, frankly. And what a support. Okay, here. So. Top lane, the harass is also being thrown out. One stun. Back though, not enough to kill Fenrir.
Ohio's gonna get burnt through pretty quickly here though, and Lanham sprints himself forward with a Shikuchi, chasing this one down, and Ohio dropping low and actually dies there. DJ not able to save his buddy. E-Home will come out the victors in that skirmish up at top, while down at bottom lane, what's happening here? Ice, and old 11 pressing forward into Fnatic. A gift from the temple. E-Home won't find anything there. Axe steady laning for now. Last hit wise, we're looking at Puck, Old Chicken. Definitely put the one up against this Invoker in the early stages. As close as it should be from the first couple of waves, but that comes down to Ice's first rotation in. Invoker gets pushed off the lane a touch, but Medusa is currently sitting at 7-1.
to touch on that, I think it's pretty important, just like trying to burn that first salve is so huge on that invoker, because if you just can't get the damage, like yeah, Puck has kind of slow cool air, you know, low cooldowns and decent damage, and the right clicks are there, but you're always playing this phase shift game with the forward spirits and everything, and it can be pretty tough to get some damage. Like mid one can just play back for a little bit, use the floss to regen, and having that support come in really does make a big difference, because that's going to give you that kill potential later on. By you harassing down to around, you know, 60, 50% HP, and then go for that Dream Coil play at level 6.
Point to the Mystic Snake for net. Trying to burn through old 11 mana, but with the poor man's shield, he's withstanding all of these right click attacks so far. Fnatic, go higher up too. I'm gonna get the swarm placed back onto him. Out of the way of that one. DJ looking for the dive in with a Scorched Earth though, and it's Doombringer.
Four tangos.
Going in deep. Fenrir, how much can you juke? He's going to try and get himself back through this end, but it looks like he's pretty stuck. In a cage of Fenrir's design, DJ and Ohio will be trapped in here for a little bit, but they can just walk themselves back out past the trees while Weaver is busy getting himself an invis rune with the bottle he's bought. Bottle, one, Bassy. Really good early game stat and regen items here for you, Weaver.
No urn today. Oh, bottom lane, here's that classic line up against the Void, but oh, they're gonna go the second one now. May have time missing things. Hold down.
Whoa!
Oh, 11. Playing a dangerous game. Doesn't even time off any of that off. A mana issue, I suppose. From the line. Oh, he doesn't even have the mana drain yet. Alright, no, I'm not sure what he's doing then.
For the 2-1-0. Oh, what? Puck? Soloed by mid one's invoker.
Sunstrike too, on the way out. Ah, well, there you go. Look for that.
So much for Puck winning the lane. Now mid one, 21 and 13. I was more worried about the Medusa down at bottom lane getting chased by Ice, as well as old 11, but that middle lane. An eye on that one. Midas is now 1,000 gold away from mid one. 5 minutes in. He can start farming the jungle as well. Spectacular start for him as old chicken. Got to be wary about where you're positioning yourselves up against this guy. How does this game progress though? If you look at net. Go for the phase boots, Aquila, maybe the drums. Linkard Sphere is going to give you a little bit of value against the Glimpse, but not really too much else. Apart from just having the stats and the regen out from it.
I kind of like one of those like Yasha Scotty builds or something like that.
Tank
up. Pretty entertaining.
Attack speed and a bit of slow to tank up as much as you can with all the stats across. Good. Ice on this Naga Siren though. Impact made minimal. He annoyed mid one a little bit, but apart from that, he hasn't really accomplished too much as Lanham, old Lanham, moves himself down towards bottom lane, leaving the Disruptor alone up atop against Ohio's Nyx Assassin. This should become apparent to Fnatic, but it hasn't. Net is going to get chased down here with a Shikuchi forward. He's got his mana shield up and the damage output. Enough out onto this Fnatic Medusa, but over towards the side, the Courier's being trapped up with the ensnare from Ice, and they kill off. What is that? Brown boots? No, it's the Wraith Band for net.
Oh, I was just thinking how Ice is kind of playing like one of those unsuccessful bounty hunters that you see these days. You know, you draft him, he can't find anything in the lane, he wanders from place to place, just soaking up EXP, and he randomly kills a courier. So he really is playing slightly unsuccessful bounty hunter, making a comeback here.
Nice. Try the gold across the rest of his team as well, and mid lane has been left open here because Puck has shifted towards top. Weaver is now in the offlane role, and Ice Naga is apparently your mid laner now. But have to be very worried about what mid one does to him, because look at the damage output with the Forge Spirits and the Cold Snap. Now the Sunstrike, he thought the Duke was coming. It wasn't. Intelligent movement there, and intelligent Sunstrike. In the end, it wasn't intelligent Duke that mid one thought was coming from Ice. It was just a straight walk in a line. Mid one now, Dream coiled up, and old 11. Starts pummeling into the server department. Forward is to get himself out of the damage range. But mid one, the fairy fire, gets himself a little bit further away. He's healed up, he's cold. Nope, he's not. He's down. An old chicken phase shift is there, but the troll trap keeps them in place. The scorched earth burns through, and old chicken orbs away a little bit further, but the infernal blade comes out of DJ and snared up by Isosize. And DJ, will he even lose his life? Four stick charges available for him to get himself back up to a decent amount of health, and he's even got the spawn skeletons to come through and try and help him out. But a Shikuchi from Lanham is all they need to secure the kill onto the Weaver on the Doom.
Well, there you see just how important it is to have that invoker down low when you actually want to try and go for that gank. Just living so long, it allows them to trade right back into for that puck. Ohio? I mean, they know we assume they have vendettas, but they're like a dangerous game. And they won't be going back to that camp.
Ohio is hunting for Fenrir. Doesn't off a nice angle to get onto the disruptor though, and they're pinging out top lane. Old 11, 800 health. The Vendetta stun. Does he have mana for mana burn as well? He does with stick arcanes. He could come out, hit, stun, arcanes, mana burn, maybe sunstrike, but instead they're just gonna go for the safer play. Ohio turns to his mate DJ and smokes up. They've got the Doom level 6 now as well, and they want to wrap in on this top lane, but look at that. Written on the map, as clear as day. Faceless Void knows what's up. They're gonna come through our jungle, look for someone, hunt for someone. And Old Chicken very patiently gonna hide himself away in the trees here.
It's hard to do that right now. Trying to farm up that Blink Dagger so desperately. Oh, it might not be enough.
Well, let's see him. DJ dooms him up. There we go, perfect start. I'll bring that Old Chicken, easy as that. EP coming through, the Chrono from Old 11, hold on, where's it going? He's not throwing it out. Oh, I'm still dropping very low stick charges there as well, but Carapace, there's the Chrono down on the 4, the damage output. Old Lanham, he's being ripped apart by the Force Prince, they've caught out one, but the Kone Kills are going to hold him in a little bit. Old 11, time walk away, get yourself away from this dangerous situation. Ice, ripped to shreds, the Sunstrike doesn't land either, but Fenrir tries to pinch his back, but DJ has an Infernal Blade in a second, slams down Fenrir, one more hit should be all he needs. He sticks around just to secure that kill and make damn sure the Disruptor is dead, while DJ Thunderstrike with the damage output from Old 11 clears him up and the orb forward. They look for that, but they're not going to get damage to 343. The Dreamcall is all they've got with a Swarm flying out. Lanham still has a lot of mana and HP remaining, but he doesn't have any left anymore. The Forge Brick clears him up with an Invoker. Mid one, clearing one after the other, and Old 11 retreating back with a beasting of health, but is taken out again with a stun from Ohio, not quite catching on to Old Chicken. E-Home, they're throwing everything they've got into this fight, but Fnatic, they still come out on top.
Yeah, action. That Chrono lead it all off too. So good for them, but losing that Weaver, not able to slip himself away. Sure, if he just didn't have the mana for the time lapse. Oh yeah, it looks like he didn't, so. Obviously, I mean, numerous situations that could have occurred that happened, but oh, this early start, it's pretty dependent, you would think, here for the side of E-Home. Like, obviously, he's not like some core Naga that's going to be there later on. I mean, so like mega late. They're working with a puck to get up into that early Blink Dagger. He just got killed behind the tower, and although he survived through that fight, I'm not sure how many bounties he... Yeah, he didn't actually pick up any.
Radiant's courier has been killed.
Pick up the courier. Nicely done.
Ice again. Our Observer Ward sees it move across. They move themselves in.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Stop.
Dire's
structure is okay. Look at that. Trying in for the old Sunstrike onto the putt. The mid one, 5-1 and 2 with the Hand of Midas, Ring of Aquila, 2,000 gold, Dire's closing in on that. While DJ looks like he's gonna take down the tier 1 up the top lane.
Bottom lane though, to the tower.
Oh, it's a good chrono. Stone Gaze though, the Stone Gaze, Old 11, he can't hit, and now comes out the heal from Net. He's actually saved himself from this one, and Old 11's taken out. The Stone Gaze procs at exactly the right time for Net to secure himself his life and a kill back onto the Void.
He was pretty well mid-swing there.
Troll
coming up from your lion. So, you know, typical plays there. 3-4-3, making sure they won't have a chance at actually bringing him down. From Lanham back. He's scooching, slithering himself in here, but not going much deeper. Obviously, DJ there with that Doom, building up into his, at least the casual player. Not going to be that drums build quite yet, or Vlad's.
Phantom shreds Bassy. Okay, he's trying to rush into that blink dagger. But Fnatic will dodge away from the swarm and they're not going to get caught here. They've even got Ohio with 1500 gold and his Vendetta ready just behind them. Looking to strike on net. He's going to go into the drums build, which he's very fond of. Just try and pad out your stats as much as possibly can in these early stages so you do not yourself susceptible to getting picked off by the nuke damage coming out of Ehome. Void though, old 11. Not far off his Vlad's. Still a faceless Void with Chrono not having a great hero to pile in damage on top. You know, Weaver, okay, you're gonna do a little bit. You're gonna tickle at them. But you've got no big OD, no Invoker, no actual AoE combo play to throw in on top of it. But Ong, start things off. The kinetic shield and the static storm as well from Fenrir, and they'll land it perfectly. Mid one and Net both caught in. They still get the tower, but mid one three gonna be taken out, and Net. Oh, he's trapped in the dream coil on top of it. The puck arrives just right time. Stone comes through from the next low until 11. Slim back into death and into the destruction. Two big kills for Ehome. And they lose the Weaver in the meantime, though, down towards the bottom lane.
At least they did get one of those bounties on top of himself. Bounty rune. He's very, very close to his blink deck. I can probably just make his way over to the side shop and pick that one up. 11 also getting close to finishing up. Oh, he is in fact finished. So that's perfect. He can set ring towards his own blink dagger. And you can see the impact there. Like, there's a song from Ice Ice Ice, but it can also work in a couple different ways. It could be after a chrono or something like that if they need to sing. Give a little bit more time for the disrupt to have a nice follow up as well. Like, you can imagine how what goes down. The chrono gets dropped, like, let's say right here. And then everyone from the raiding side comes to help. And then suddenly song gets popped. And then you can reset. You can change up the fight, decide who you now want to go into. Maybe Net's low at this point, so you kill these two static storm and then you kill Net. Definitely see how this is gonna work. I've never seen this actual trio go to town before. Top lane, they do have the Doom on top of Ice, running away. The Sunstrike didn't connect, but obviously, no doubt eventually. Question is, can you make it to creeps?
Nope, you cannot. Arcane's mech on Doom. Fighting battle build here for DJ. You're going for the Blink Dagger next as he TP's down towards bottom lane.
Smoked up bottom. 11, thrown already.
Net is very far up on the front lines and mid one. They're trying to keep the split as distant as they can, which is why Net moved further towards the east. Old Chicken and Old 11, Blink Dagger and Time Walk ready and available. Net, the lone target here though for Ehome if they want to try and jump in on anything, and the tower's already dead. A TP coming through, who's this? Another Siren stunned up. Ice, there's no song for the Chrono. Mid one's gonna catch the Invoker alone. Oh, Fnatic. They stand the ground with the stone gaze out. Old 11's caught in place as well. Mid one's still alive. The Chrono's wasted and the hex comes through. Old 11 stunned up as well. 3-4-3. Earthspike not gonna land. And Old 11 tumbles himself back a little bit further to safety. And that static storm drops on the two. Net DJ caught in that death zone with the deafening blast from mid one. Keeps them all pushed further back. And Ehome. Oh, do they have anywhere to go? Do they have anywhere to hide? Fenrir definitely doesn't. Trapped up by Ohio and DJ. And now they're looking for Old Chicken. Orb and Fate ready and available. Old Chicken gonna get him. Oh no! He's raining rift into the carapace. All he had to do was orb and shift and jump himself back. But he went for the sly play with a silence, and he'll pay with his life. Ehome. Tragic. Tragic course of events there for them.
That's one of those situations that just shows how powerful these vision heroes are, like your Beastmaster. When they're sitting here, and they have, you know, the tower was still up, it was nighttime, they had vision to right here. All they could see was a Medusa and an Invoker. They had no idea where the supporting heroes were back here. Like, you could see a couple moments where there was like a four-man Chrono. He had, you know, popped out, could have got it even with range of the time walk, but you just can't see things without it. There is a quick blink up there for Ohio. They are gonna lose their faceless Void.
Of death definitely helps. Net is alone up at top lane, but he's told to get the hell away from that area there. Ehome, what's it looking like? What's the damage? 1,000 or so net worth lead for Fnatic, climbing up from 5k. 3.5, 4,000 a lead in experience as well. As you're looking at these bigger items coming through, the Yule Scepter on Invoker. 100 gold on your Doom after Mech Arcane. The Etherlander is nearly done here for your Nyx Assassin. 3-4-3's Lion, who's the hard 5, buying Observer Wards and Sentries. Blink Dagger really isn't far from him either. It's just Net on the Medusa that, you know, needs a little bit of a a bit of a slower ramp-up time to get into these items. Being given space, it's exactly like I was looking for. The Medusa or the Spectre, same kind of story. Four heroes ganking, one hero farming.
And once again, like, Ehom's trapped. Come on, though, combo for sure. It's got some elements of comeback potential, but...
I'm gonna disagree with you. I don't think it's a wombo combo.
It's like a
wombo wombo or a combo combo.
Yeah, exactly. It's too many working pieces that need to happen all in tandem, and there's a Doom.
It's got like
there's Stone Gaze.
It's got like three
from Carapace.
There's like three from column A and none from column B.
Yeah.
Three setup skills with Song, Dream Call, Chrono. Maybe, you know, maybe a bit of column B with the Disruptor and the Weaver, just a touch of damage, a bit of extra annoyance in there from them as well, but Assassin, he is angry and on the hunt. These illusions going to trick Fnatic as they are smoked up by the Ohio, moves himself further forward here and looks for Ice. Arc of Siren. Stun to the Song of the Siren and stun, not gonna land from Ohio. Double stun in the same place. Blink back from the Nyx Assassin will save him. The question is, can Net survive as well? Static Storm. Now, old Chrono drops first. The kill off 343. Down goes the Lion Net. Stun Strike will land on top of his head, but it's a friendly one for the Stun Cup through for Ice Ice Ice. They've caught out the Naga Siren. Ginkgo's not going to do anything at all here. Old 11 trying to get back in, but decides that not worthwhile running into the Stony Lady. Net manages to control Old 11. Old Chicken. They jump themselves into a old team fight here. Fnatic is happy at chipping away this tier 2 tower.
I really think Fnatic nailed it with this Medusa pick. Not only do you have the Nyx Assassin, who's classic, you know, stopping these wombo combos, your Darkseer counter. Then going to the Stone Gaze, so if things don't get synced up perfectly, you don't have Net involved in this non-stop silence. Just pops the Stone Gaze and everything's broken. You can't keep going on mid one. You can't keep going on DJ or Ohio or whoever you've got locked down at that moment. We've already talked about how they're lacking so much in damage. It's just, it has to be perfect here at this point. And the lanes just had to go, I think, a little bit better maybe for Ehome. They needed just like this slight lead early on, a quick Deso maybe. But again, we're picking a Weaver into a Doom and a Lion, so... How does your game have to go to get a Deso first?
And a 4-roll Doom here who nearly has as much net worth as the 1-roll Weaver. DJ absolutely cruising his way through this gold. 20-minute Guardian Greaves, 130 gold. So simple, while 343 not going for the straight-up Blink Rush. Into a Cloak before that one. Maybe he goes for Tourmacape and then into Blink, something like that, but we'll see which direction he heads. On mid one. Travel Yules, the Blink or the Aghanim Scepter next, and he has become this unstoppable force here for Fnatic, allowing them to control up all these teamfights, and you look at Net every time. He's always on a lane alone, but Ehome, I don't know if they're scared or if they just don't think they can kill him, because they don't go for him. They don't go for these five-man smokes. They instead go for the head-on-head clashes. They go for the tier 1 trades. They go for these battles. But if they just keep vision of Net, I think they could go and pick him off.
Seems to be that, like, how are they going to kill him? Are they going to use everything they have? And then what are they going to do in the next fight? Like, all their damage comes from these ultimates, and all their control even from the vast majority is all just ultimates, like Dream Coils and a Chronosphere or something, and then if you're missing those tools, how are you going to take the next fight? It seems they're still limited on options.
Ward.
You can just set up a rush.
11's up on his high ground with Lanham nearby as well, and Ohio goes for the little swipe there of the bounty rune, but he's not going to catch it. Old 11 still in this spot, but he's seen. He's been pinged out here by the rest of Fnatic, and he'll TP himself away. But Ohio's Nyx Assassin, 3, 2, and 6. Guy. Can be an absolute nuisance in these team fights. Spike Carapace against the Initiation from Puck is amazing. Spike Carapace and some mana burn against the Weaver. This Lincoln Sphere, like, sure enough, it's going to block out the Doom, maybe. But a level 4 mana burn on a 4-second cooldown, you know that Ohio is going to be spamming that shit on Weaver every chance he can.
a little bit of an unusual build going for like the 4-3-2. We'll tend to see a couple points put in here or there on the Nyx Assassin, depending to that in multiplier. You never really know how valuable it's going to be. Obviously, very nice game for you. Trying to work on that Lincoln Spear, probably the best thing in their arsenal, really. Just lower that cooldown down to 4. Spoken, and they are the Radiant, I think. A lot of peek of them there. A little bit hard to tell. See if their actions suggest otherwise. Doesn't seem like they're aware.
Pushed up very far past this river.
They're in the pit.
I saw his swords up on the high ground as well.
See them all. Oh my god, this looks familiar. Naga leading the charge. Like.
I was thinking that as well, but. There's no Light of Heaven, BKB, Black Hole, Enigma here for Fnatic. They do have 343 Glimmer Cape Lion over on the wings, though. And with the jump forward, Ohio, well, net is caught, but the Doom with a Hexhole Chicken. Static Storm's up on two of them, but ulting is called Doom Double. Jumping towards forward, Stone Gate as well, Ice Event Stun. And net will take him apart. Old Chicken being wiped down by the Doom DJ. Make sure that's his focus and priority. And Fenrir dropped as well, 3-0. And Nyx Assassin might even find Old 11 over to the side. Blink's on cooldown, I mean TP's on cooldown. A blink, ready in 2 for Ohio, but they'll just let him go, let him be. Rest of the team will push up onto high ground here. Tier 3, ready, ripe for the taking. E-Home in a little bit of trouble. As Fnatic take a firm grasp on game number 1.
They call it the misplay. No, but not really. I mean, they had to make an action happen, right? They had to go. They know that's the only way they're going to win this game. So make an attempt, make that both play, but... quite find the right angle, can't get that song initiation going. Without that, I mean, it's just a little disaster, right? You don't want to throw out the Chrono first, you don't want to throw out the Static Storm first, you're waiting for this perfect all our damage everywhere that we need it. They don't end up losing anything crucial, just power, but again, it's just more mounting pressure, more opening of the space for the Roshan, bigger items coming out. You've got the Agnum Scepter up on the mid one, 6-2-10, he's crushing it. That's gonna have items.
25 minutes. 13k net worth, Ags, the OT is yours, now a Sunstrike onto Disruptor. I just barely caught that, only because I was looking at mid one, actually casting the Sunstrike himself. 3-4-3, he did go for the Glimmer Cape. This is a dream game for the Invoker though, like the only thing he's missing now is the Blink Dagger. Okay, we'll get rid of that Brand, buy a Blink Dagger, go on.
I didn't notice he was still, Branch over... any, I guess, I mean, yeah.
He has BOT, so doesn't need TP.
Yeah, instead of just take your branch. Okay.
How's your GG branch, you know? Efficiency item in the game. That's the goal. Beautiful, it's perfect, it's a flower. Oh, Ohio. No heroes here. I saw them both jump in, I was like, hang on a second. Has anyone got a creep wave? 11 has his blink now though. This could lead to a big Chronosphere and a big setup for E-Home. Let's find the opportunity to do it. Damn. They know they need to start getting rid of these wards. They're just Radiant wards and observers everywhere on their lanes. Movements, smokes, up to these team fights. Head back into the Desolator, but Fnatic, they are smoked towards this middle lane themselves as well. Net leads the charge. Oh.
Mules. I guess they know they need to split this game to go on, but that is kind of crazy.
Fuck, yeah. Juicer. Pretty good right now. Mantis style is ready, delivered. As we were saying, it's not going to be that Lincoln's build, just because Lincoln's doesn't get you a lot of value here across the board against your home's heroes. But Mantis style and Scardy definitely will. Tank up, stand your ground and right click away, because E-Home, they want to dogpile in onto a couple of heroes inside this setup they've got. Oh, Ohio, there's the stun into Sunstrike, and they've got him perfectly. Old Chicken. Not stand a chance.
Everything's just closing in on them. See just how like far and away they're going. And this ward will spot out the Invoker, so perhaps Old 11 will be able to make an escape here. Medusa's, you know, she's just chilling with Roshan. She's totally soloing it with those Man, this is how waiting for someone to please come help me. And so maybe they'll come down. Not too concerned about Olevin's station. There we go. There comes another smoke. Do they have one? Oh, they only have smokes? Oh, they're gonna just run. They're not gonna be there in time for the song. Are they? Maybe?
Oh no.
Hurry!
If they had moved straight away, yes. But they waited for the smoke to come for Fenrir. And now it might be too late. The Nargisauron's running herself full with a swarm into the pit. It doesn't look like it's too late. The Song of the Sauron's ready for Ice. He's gonna throw it. No, he's holding a little bit longer, trying to wait this one out and then jump into the rush pit. Ice. They look for Roshan. All 11 trying to take it out. They get the edge of the mortal over to the weave as well. Dark Storm King Shield holds them in place for the use of the mid one. Catches him, sends him out to the air. He's gonna try and save himself in this one. Turns back to the action, catch the force move, back on the two of the figure, just kills off one as well. And mid one, still alive, ready with the force move back again onto the Lanham. But this Weaver, he's too quick for that. DJ, Doom's already expended, and Lanham's Weaver trying to race himself away. 3-4-3's up on the high ground as well. But Ehome, even with the Roshan Steel, the Aegis pickup, and a great setup with Void and Disruptor, it just wasn't enough. Everything they had to do there, they did pretty much perfectly, but it wasn't enough.
I guess, like, the one thing that you kind of think when you see the fight is that they stack the Static Storm and the Chronosphere, but they don't have a choice, because at this point, the Doom's so firm, the DJ just has a blink. So, if you don't, you know, if one person's just waiting, again, one of these moving pieces for this, like, perfect, cohesive team fight that this draft needs to be successful, you're just gonna get blink Doom. And you're not gonna be able to get off that Chronosphere, so you just throw it out. And that's really the best you can do. It allows them to at least stay in the Static Storm for a little bit longer. So,
dead for 53 seconds, and without his Chronosphere, maybe not worth buying back here. Net just trying to take down his barracks, old 11, old Lanham even. Oh, but surely right click down, Static Storm's ready now. Nargisauron, of course, still no song for a long ass time. All one song at level 11. Full lane of Rakdos, the bottom lane, go. Fnatic closing in on this game number one victory, 30 minutes in, on the back of mid one's Invoker, 9-2 and 11 with a full BKB completed now. Sunstrike, be armed. Waiting for the place to throw it. Ohio, Static Storm. Gonna catch anyone. It does force Net deeper into the space though, as Medusa stands her ground. And Sunstrike not gonna land onto Ice, but Net, we're dropping low on the old mana pool and then limps back into the connected field. Do Fnatic need to go and fight this one to save Net? Doesn't look like they do. Net is tanky enough as it is. The Dreamclaw expended on the Medusa alone, and Lanham just cannot do enough damage to this. The alacrity of the Net means he just keeps on ripping them apart while Ice up on the front end is doomed to kill. The gem is dropped, the Courier takes it out, Chrono lands, catching out Net and DJ, but Lion, but he's a punch, and Lanham, oh Ohio, barely getting out of the kill, but still with different last media, old Lanham cleared up, and Ehome, they've got nothing left in the tank. Fenrir and old Lanham, last people standing, but GG is called, and Fnatic will take game number one here in this best of three. Dire's middle
tower is under attack. And you look at it, you think to yourself, where is the damage going to come from? That seemed to be the story of the game. I mean, I guess maybe that first rotation of the Phasis Void goes flawlessly, and from there you just keep going and going and going. You go between Dream Coil and Chronosphere, just on and on and on. Your Weaver gets a couple kills, you get farmed up. Your laning stage had to go better for sure, like maybe a little bit more pressure on that Medusa. Obviously had way too good of a time, and then mid one as well, winning that matchup.